Yeah, so hello everyone. Today I will have a pleasure to play a Banter Breeze against Miroshinchenko Yevgeny. Haven't played him, so I'm looking forward to this match. And actually I'm in Croatia. Tomorrow starts the Grand Chess Tour here. So hopefully I will manage also technically. Yeah, but let's start the game. I'm very grateful that he allowed, this match to start at such a late hour. Yeah, but he disconnected, I think. Or... yeah, today been a busy day. Have the opening ceremony. Nice to meet the guys, especially Garry Kasparov, who will play the Blitz. Looking forward to this as well. Yeah, I'm not sure if he's... yeah, okay. So, I'm on the zone him now. Yeah, actually, I haven't prepared for this match. Probably also wouldn't if I had more time, but yeah, now my mind is on the Grand Chess Tour, so hopefully I will we'll play a very interesting match today. And okay, so before knight f6, interesting to see. Six, let's play a3. Seven, bishop f4. It's kind of trendy these days. Actually, I have always played bishop f4 in the fourth move, but this is kind of similar. Just with f7 included. Knight d4 is of course normal. He has less space, so it's important for him to exchange pieces. But now also I can start this h4 and g5. It's very trendy. Also the very old games, Spassky Pogaevsky comes to mind. Yeah, so knight g5, I guess knight f6 then. Yeah, I play it anyway. Let's make castle. Because obviously it's important that after h6 he can't take the dizzy this knight on g5. So he will most likely get checkmated on the h5. So well, actually I'm not sure how to proceed further. Like what to do. G4 is very natural, but what's the point of this move? Okay, e5, that makes sense once I have played this g4. I guess I will just play bishop g3. Maybe d queen f5, queen c8. Also doesn't look bad. d queen f5, maybe bishop d6. Bishop g3 then, queen c8. Oh, but I don't want to allow this. D, I guess, then d5 maybe, but after d5 I have always bishop d5, which might be annoying for him. Okay, 6. Let's play f3. Oh, that's possible for him. Just play, I don't know, queen c2, maybe queen f1 even. I don't know, I don't buy it. Maybe knight takes g4 here is the idea. Just like that, without queen h2. Yeah, I'm not sure. No, it's very bad for him. Actually, I'm winning by force. Took g5, I'm winning the bishop. So I'm not sure what was this, h6, g5. And maybe knight takes g4 was a move. Yeah, so that was very smooth, actually. Unexpectedly. Okay. Yeah, not sure. Yeah, because if he didn't take this pawn, like this knight, then I would struggle to find some plan, I think. Okay, just king g3, let's play e6. Actually, he might want to go for the Catalan. Bishop on e7. Classical line, but it's better to give a check on d4 first and then move after bishop d2, play bishop e7 back, because this bishop on d2 is kind of a bad piece. Now, maybe d2 is the idea, and d4, of course. Let's play bishop b7, for knight a6. A5 is perfectly natural, of course. Now I get a3. Okay, cd. Now I can take back, of course, but also can play knight b4 and knight c5. I think it's nice for me to have knight on d5, but now on the other hand, maybe cd and bishop a6. Yeah, looks very good to me. I don't have problem with this light squared bishop anymore. Actually, I'm close to winning the exchange now. Maybe I am actually after rook b1, there is knight c2. And after rook b1, bishop b2. However, there might have been some knight b3 and bishop f6 business. Okay, so now I can take, but I think I won't. Because you can't really avoid losing the exchange. If he wants to play knight b3, I guess, or knight takes f1, followed by bishop h6, that's why rook b8. And just to have bishop f8 or b6. Before I will play rook c8. No rush at all. Yeah, so my position is better, but it's not so simple actually, because I'm stuck with this knight on c2. Yeah, I think I just take this. Let's take this, because now rook d1 was an option. Obviously, he will take with bishop, I think, or maybe bishop d3. I'll play knight f8 to cover the h7 pawn. Actually, it's a bit difficult to organize an attack for him. On the other hand, I'm not sure how to develop, because he has some positional compensation. But queen a4, queen d3 might be annoying for him. Then queen a2 or knight x3 might be threats. I think after queen a4 is b3. But b3 is kind of weakening, I think. So queen c6, queen c3 would be possible. Actually, b3 and bishop b2 is what I missed. So b3, maybe queen a5 is a better move. Or g6. Okay. Take with pawn. And g5 is the idea, I guess. No, but then d4 is hanging. would be free. Yeah, I think I will give that action back. Just knight takes a3, followed by queen takes b2. Because his right square pressure was the only piece actually that could cause me some trouble. Yeah, it's also important there's no knight g5, because then the bishop on d2 would drop. Yeah, now I can play h6. I even don't have to. It's my g5 that is always 67. Okay, maybe just knight c4. The knight g5, I think I'm going to take on d2. And there is no checkmate. We'll play bishop c1. I mean, he might, but then queen d4. He still can play knight g5. Yeah, so it looks too easy to be good, to be honest. Yeah, queen d4. Play a5. That's a5, a4, I think. a5, queen e7 back. Okay, queen h4. Still can play a3. Don't look back. Okay, so that's the idea. Now queen b2, looks tempting, followed by knight d3 check, bishop seven. After bishop c1, I think I will just put me c2. C2 looks good. I can't really spot any single threat here. Like knight g5 is always met by queen f5, so play a2. Rook takes h7 is an option, but after, I don't know, I can possibly take this on h7 with king, h5, king h8. It's close to winning, but also I can just promote the queen or something. Okay, queen f5. Queen e7 on the move. After that, I was going to play h6, I think. And still h6. g5. All right. Okay, I can be fancy and play knight g6, followed by rook f8. However, there is bishop f6 move. Oh, I think it doesn't make sense. Just knight d3 check is crushing, you know. Yeah, so somehow two apparently very easy looking games. Not sure what's going on. Let's play the Trompowski. Iruja played like this. I mean, the very same move. The very same moves against me, and I got a very bad position. The queen a5 check. Because I was basically a couple of tempies down. Normal Sicilian looking position. So I'm willing to do the same. Just develop. Pretend that my moves were like more sensible than his. obviously I'm not giving up my Gorskut bishop. Let's play g4. H6 is only put early, stops g5. But long castle, if he wants to play rook c8, followed by rook c3, sacrifice, I think. Let's play this anyway. So rook c8, just knight e2. Okay, so he just wants to develop. Let's play king b1. It's almost always useful in these kind of positions. Yeah, what to do now? Not going to castle. Just play with king on e8, I guess. Rook c8, b5, and so on. Put my bishop on b3. Then this Yugoslav attack against the dragon. And now he's going to take, I think. Well, then I can action queen, so I'm not sure that's so great for him. Okay, knight c5, I just go knight e2. Now e5 is in the air. Not immediately because of knight takes b3. Queen takes e5, but might be an option. And now CB is like more typical recapture. Just to have my king very safe. Also, I might use this C line one day. Bishop c6, so he wants to play just knight d7, I think. Yeah, now I can play bishop d4. Let's play bishop d4. Now he can castle, but after that, just g5, I think. I'm much quicker with my attack. b5 is actually kind of annoying now. Because knight d5 might be more difficult to play. Actually, after b5, I can take on f6. By knight d5. However, I'm not so sure this endgame is so great for me. So after the b5 before, I can just play knight e4. Or maybe rook c1 and after b4. Okay. Castle, then g5, I think. I guess it's not so simple to attack here. Let's take this. And now I want to play rook g1 followed by rook g5. The idea. g1, I guess. Or maybe rook hg1. Okay, queen g5, rook g5, anyway. Okay, now just queen g2, I think. It's good to me. Obviously, I'm not going to trade queens here, because I want to attack. Rook h5 was a threat, so obviously he played rook g8. Simple to break through. Actually, I like the idea of playing b5 and getting access to d5 square. After a6, I might play a4. Very tempting to me. Although it's obviously not the wing I should be playing on. Okay, it's kind of beginning, I think. Let's play this b5. Takes, bishop e8, maybe. Bishop d7, I thought the bishop would be hanging. It's still not so easy. Once I capture this pawn, he will play, for example, bishop e8, and it's kind of solid. But I am both better and ahead in material, so it counts for something. And what to do now? Actually, it's difficult to find a sensible move here. Yeah, very difficult. Start with d1, I don't know what for. So not to blunder this rook on d6. And now knight d4 might be an idea. After that, there is d8 ball. Maybe rook g1 is the idea. Actually, let's play rook g1. Knight f6, there is h5. Can just play bishop d7. I won on time, so. Yeah, so that was a gift. Yeah, I thought he might have some internet issues. D5, knight d7. Plays g3. He doesn't. Knight f6. c6. Queen c2. After queen c2, I think g6 is okay. After queen b3 might be smarter move order. I mean, at least g6 is not so strong after that. And I suppose. Okay, now it's some group like position. I'm going to play c5. I think straight away. This queen on c2 is kind of misplaced. Obviously, I lost tempo on c6, c5, but still, these pieces are not so well placed, I think, to meet that. Yeah, now knight xc5, knight b4. Yeah, I guess I will just take the pawn. Although knight b4 is also, oh, but knight bishop b5, I think is another pawn, because after knight takes d3, it's also the idea I spotted. Now dc, and he can recapture this pawn because of bishop d3 fork. Yeah, so he will take on b7, but then, for example, bishop b4. Yeah, just think bishop b4 is good. Take on f3 and weaken his king somewhat. Queen d5. Well, I can be fancy and play c3. It was very cool. I just can't. This is a temptation to play this move. Bishop d3 is clearly the idea. And he just wants to give that chance. I think he doesn't have enough compensation for it, but still two knights, healthy constructor. Maybe queen d7 is an annoying move for him. Because obviously he doesn't want to trade queens here. Queen h4, so some attacks. Okay, see, I'm just developing all the pieces. Okay, so now. Yeah, I think I just queen b7, followed by knight d5, possibly. Actually, after b3, there might be rook takes d4 tactics. But actually, it's holding for him, I think. After rook takes, queen takes, knight d8, there's queen d5 move, or queen e4. So after b3, I will just play knight d5, I think. Yeah, because I basically want to exchange everything here. I just win with the extra exchange. Knight f4. Maybe rook c4 to provoke b3 and then rook c2 was kind of smart to me. Yeah, rook c2. I don't want to play queen c6 because knight d3 and there are some forks. Because queen c8 is like bulletproof. No way to blunder anything. And I think I'm just winning the pawn a2. Okay, knight d4. Still can take on a2, obviously. It looks as if I am winning somehow, but I'm not quite sure. Yeah, because once I lose pawn in 7, he always has some tricks. Okay, let's take this anyway. Not waste time. Now I need to be a bit hard. I think I will just double the rooks. Yeah, but after rook d6, there is knight g5, h5, and some knight d4 business. The queen e7 and just queen d7, I think. Unless he wants to try and play knight d4, climbing this fortress, which shouldn't be. He doesn't. Oh, I don't like this rook d6, but knight d4, my rooks are misplaced, so. Something else would be. Okay, he plays. Oh, no, but no, knight no, g5. Yeah, knight d4, obviously. Yeah, there are always some tricks with knights, unfortunately. After knight g5, I think I have to play like f5. After queen c4, with such an open king. Yeah, but knight d4, he didn't see that. Yeah, rook c8. It's still not so easy to convert this. Because everything defended, and also knight is a bit annoying. Play rook d5 with the idea of rook dc5. Also, I think I will play a5. Yeah, just a5, not to allow any rook a6. c5. No, I don't think he's going to. Yeah, to work from the rooks, so just take queen d6. Yeah, now what? Yeah, let's play queen e5. It's harassing a bit. Oh, he exchanged. It's kind of strange, but also it's not so easy to break in this position. Let's play rook d3. Another rook happy because he wants to play d4. That makes perfect sense, of course. And can't really avoid this. Okay, so I will just play king g7. Before, I guess, takes, takes. Rook e7. Try to convert this somehow. Obviously, I have to. Attack the f2 pawn. Yeah, he offered me a draw, but I just played too quickly. Seriously, consider this option, but I think it's one-sided game. So, yeah, now some pawn games might be winning for me. Rook c4, king e5. I mean, let's try the way, but king e5. Blunder anything. Nah, actually it might be fortress, but I think I can try to squeeze this forever. So no draw. Mr. Evgeny this time. Yes, but which one? Yeah, knight c3, so the other is knight d4 after king c4. It's kind of unpleasant for him. Yeah, but I also have. Doesn't have. Well, now it's almost a blunder, knight g2. Yeah, king f3. What about king f3? Let's give the check. Yeah, I think he blundered his check. Now g5. Yeah, he's just winning the three and the rook takes f2. Winning the knight. Yeah, so that was, yeah, it was probably a fortress, but obviously I was the one pushing, so that's nothing strange, I think. Yeah, so it's 4-0 somehow. I don't know how I'm doing this, but by the name, so let's sit on 85 straight away. Yeah, so now it's maybe just a queen's gambit. If I play knight f3, well, I might try to be clever and play some queen c2. I don't know, not so long castle stuff. And I will just play knight f3. Okay, knight d4, it's the last card. Very solid. Hikaru Nakamura likes to play like that. I mean, he always chooses this option. Yeah, and what to do now? Okay, let's play rook c1. Obviously, my line. Yeah, now h4 g4 is tempting, but maybe it doesn't make so much sense. Let's play normal bishop d3. Yeah, it's very solid for him, but he needs to win, so I don't mind drawing, to be honest. And maybe queen c2 was smarter, so there are 3-5, there is 4. Okay, let's play bishop d3. I want to play bishop d4 one day. But 5, still bishop d4. It's a bit better for white and also extremely solid, so. I don't mind. Just DC, I think. also played bishop c6 actually. After queen d6. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do after queen. Queen d6, I'll just let's play. Let's make it simple. C2. Obviously, this position is not that easy. We should not want such a game against the same top power in their match. Yeah, now I don't know e4. I don't want to play e4 to be honest. It's double edged sword. Ad2 first. Only after queen g5, I think they will play e4. Yeah, now it's important not to blunder anything because suddenly my position is suddenly a bit losing. Probably c1. But I don't like it. C1, I think. Yeah, not sure how to win this, but instead I don't have to at all, so let's play b3. So that my pawn is not hanging on d2 anymore. After queen g5, knight d4. Takes, rook d2. It's fine for black, but also fine for white, so why to bother? Okay, rook d5, I think. Let's play rook c1 and knight, followed by another one. Maybe actually knight f3 back makes sense now. It's rook on d5. I could also knight f1, there is some bishop e6. Let's play knight f3. And now I'm going to play h3. He doesn't move his rook from d5, of course, and I have the idea of just taking on c5. H3. Yeah, I think it's just going to retry just. Everything will be traded and zero. King h2, bishop takes f3, gf, rook d2, king g2. Unfortunately, there is no way to keep this pawn, like to play a4 or something. I can't quite see, so. Yeah. Except for the draw, so. Yeah, I don't know what's happening. Yeah, so 4.5, if nothing has changed in this final, I think I have just won. Unless something has changed, which I'm not aware of. Yeah, so that was, I don't know, somehow I won just for these games very, very quickly and like, yeah, internet was obviously, you know, I guess was a reason, actually, because he lost some time in the first game. So yeah, somehow I, again, have managed to win like almost to zero. It's kind of nice, but especially now, considering that I was, yeah, considering myself to be tired after this opening ceremony. It's okay. Thank you for your time. It's been quite smooth, to be honest. And yeah, see you next time.